Welcome to Sync Quick News. Last episode, we looked at Trump's little COVID charade, noting the explicit nature of the drug name Regeneron, aka Regeneration of the King, as well as him sending an email from the hospital calling Obama Lion Obama. Again, the lion, as plain as day, just calling this symbolism out by name. And if after all that there was any doubt about how this was an attempt by Trump to mirror Barack Obama's 2011 said festival, we got this batshit crazy update from the New York Times. Quote, "When he left the hospital, he wanted to appear frail at first when people saw him. But underneath his button-down dress shirt, he would wear a Superman t-shirt, which he would reveal as a symbol of strength when he ripped open the top layer. He ultimately did not go ahead with the stunt. He has since continued playing this idea up. Quote, President Donald Trump told a rally in Nevada he felt like Superman after doctors gave him a COVID-19 antibody cocktail called Regeneron. Again, Regeneron, the regeneration of the king. And as we enter the final weeks before the election, he keeps making this Superman thing more and more a prominent part of his shtick. Now, if you watched my series Hindsight 2020, you may recall that I spent some time in the second episode detailing all the ways Obama was portrayed as an embodiment of the sun throughout his presidency. He was the Solar King. Well, that is, to everyone who didn't see him as the Antichrist. Now we see Trump trying to don the garb of Sun King, you know, to everyone who doesn't see him as the Antichrist. One thing I didn't take the time to dwell on in that episode was that as part of Obama's solar messiah routine, he was regularly depicted as Superman, who gains his powers from the sun.
Contrary to the rumors that you've heard, I was not born in a manger. I was actually born on Krypton and sent here by my father, Jor-El, to save the planet Earth.
That was such a common motif that it was silly. So to see Trump trying to wear this specific aspect of the Sun King motif and claim it as his own, it is truly mind-boggling how seemingly obsessed he is with wearing the skin of the lion as his own.
Who do you fuck with? I'd fuck this song.
I showed in Hindsight 2020 Episode 3 how the wearing of the lion skin throughout the said festival was intended to mirror the fake, simulated death and rebirth of the pharaoh with the mythic death and rebirth of Osiris. So you may be interested to know that NASA this week reached a major milestone by touching down on an asteroid as part of their subtly titled OSIRIS-REx program. That's right, NASA literally calls this OSIRIS-REx, King Osiris. Goro Adachi points out that the asteroid itself is also named Bennu, which is the name of the Egyptian phoenix, the symbol of resurrection. Now, if after all I've shown you there is any doubt this whole ritual is about rebirthing the king, let us go to NASA. This is literally the first reaction of the team leads within a minute of their project's success.
Oh my gosh, we're there, folks. That was amazing. I mean, I don't know if you saw the team here, but they just kind of blew up. They went from being steely-eyed to like celebrating the Super Bowl. So it's all good. This is amazing. So congratulations, everybody. I know that Dante and Dr. Zabrukin are right here. And Dante, you somehow got over here pretty quick.
I sure did.
Congratulations. How you guys feeling?
Transcendental. I mean, I can't believe we actually pulled this off. God, I'm so excited about the team. Yeah. Hey, do you mind if I just bring up something?
Please.
Our friend, Mike Drake, is with us right now.
That's
the
right.
The guy who came up with the mission at the beginning, and we're thinking of him. He's no longer on Earth, but I feel him right here.
I agree. He's with us today, and I know he's incredibly proud of this team and everything we have accomplished. This is history.
Osiris Rex, the Sun King who dies and is reborn just like Superman.
The infant of Krypton is now the Man of Steel, Superman, able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
There is, however, another side to this symbolism. Nick Ulbrich shared these stories with me where a man hangs himself off Trump Tower, enacting both the archetypal hanged man and tower Trump cards of the Tarot. But here's the thing, that's just days after Biden-Harris is projected onto the very same Trump Tower. In one more update from Nick Ulbrich, he has been messaging me regularly telling me to pay attention to the finals of the Australian Football League, where we previously saw the Lions and Tigers go head-to-head. Well, the final four rounds got down to Tigers, Power, Lions, and Cats. That's a fuckton of cat energy right there. This weekend, the final game features Tigers versus Cats. Both symbols I focused on in episode 3 of Hindsight 2020. As you may recall, T.S. Eliot's Cats was a part of this symbolic parade. Viewers who are looking for clues in this will likely want to see how that match plays out in the next few days. Before I go, I have some news of my own. This will likely be my last Sync Quick News for a while, as I feel like I've been sucked back into a news cycle that is dictated by others, and that's not how I want to spend my time. One of the reasons I so enjoyed doing Hindsight 2020 was to pull back out of that news cycle and get some bigger perspective by retracing my steps over a larger window of time. On that same note, I have another huge major item to share with you. A book that I've been working on for quite some time to help get it to press, a book by Zenor, who was one of my absolute favorite authors, is finally out and ready for you to grab a copy. The book is called Death Sweat of the Cluster and features 27 essays written between 2012 and 2015, cleaned up and curated to tell a story of that period. In addition to really diving into a lot of this wasteland ritual material, as well as the overarching exploration of what that means for us. I can't possibly recommend this book enough. Please grab a copy right now. I'll put a link for that down in the show notes, as well as a link to another book. If anyone enjoyed my film Vision and the Voice from 2018, if you haven't seen it, it's free. You can watch it online right now. Well, I needed to test a new printing service for Zenor's book, and I did so by putting together a transcript of that Vision and the Voice film, and it turned out way cooler than I expected. It is super cheap, only $6, and again, makes a really neat artifact. And lastly, in a few weeks from now, when everyone is making a big deal about a contested election, while I won't be here with a new video for you, I hope you'll go back and watch Hindsight 2020 Episode 5 again, because you'll see that I already covered that topic and intentionally laid the groundwork for you to make some sense of this coming chaos.
And I would suggest to you that that call on election night had more to do with making George Bush president than any recount or ballot design issue.
I wish you all and myself the best of luck in the near future. I hope my video series and Zenor's book can help serve as some guideposts along the way. I will see you again a little further on down the road.